secret card that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty and the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to a kitchen chair, she broke your throne, she cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Maybe I have been here before. I know this room, I've walked this floor. I used to live alone before I knew you. I've seen your flag on the marble arch. Love is not a victory march, it's a cone and it's a broken hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Was a time you let me know what's real and going on below, but now you never show it to me, do you? And remember when I moved in you, the holy dark was moving too, and every breath we drew was hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Maybe there's a God above, and all I ever learned from love was how to shoot at someone who outdrew you. It's not a cry you can hear at night, it's not somebody who's seen the light, it's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
My name is Zach Schiffer. I'm a pastor of a church, longtime friend of Justin's. So it's an honor for me to be here with all of you as well. Who gives this bride to be married today?
Oh, sorry.
Great. And Robert. All right, before we get started today, we have to lay out a few ground rules. This one, I know that this first one's going to be a little tough for this family, but that's okay. Justin and Alejandra have designated folks to be our photographers for today, and they asked that the rest of you put your cameras away so that we can just be present, so that we can be here to remember, to witness these vows that they're going to share with one another, declare to one another. today. And John, I'm looking at you. Keep an eye on you. Get those cameras tucked away. The second thing is that each of you have a role to play here today. These two are making vows to one another, but we all bear witness to these vows. We all are here to support this couple. We're all here to lift them up when they have difficult times. We're all making a commitment to them to be there, hopefully someday when there's some babysitting needed, when there's some prayer needed, some support in any way we can lend to this couple, to see them blessed, to see them growing closer together, to see their marriage thrive. And so thank you for being here. Thank you for honoring them with your presence today. Well, Justin and I have known each other since working at a church together. We were friends even before that. And we often had some very, 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 very long conversations. And so when he asked me to join you guys in your wedding and to give a message, he probably wasn't thinking much of what you guys wanted or needed, because if you give a pastor a mic, this could go on forever, especially talking to Justin. No, we won't go too long today. But I am going to share some scripture with us here today, and you guys can just listen. I'll read it for us. You can just soak it all in. And we're going to start in a place that many weddings don't. If you look in the book of Ecclesiastes, there's wisdom there shared with us by King Solomon. And the theme of the book, the direction he takes this whole thing, is echoed over and over and over again, where he seeks purpose and meaning for his life in about every area. He seeks wisdom in every place he can find it. And he comes to the conclusion over and over again that it's all vanity. He says, vanity of vanities, all is vanity. This is one of Justin's favorite books of the Bible. When we go searching for meaning in our lives, we can search in many, many, many places. And many of those searches, many of those hunts turn up empty, turn up meaningless. But we are searching for meaning here today in this ceremony. And so we go to the scriptures, we go to the Creator to ask him what he says. And this Creator, God Almighty, he took dust, the same dust that King Solomon referred to when he said, from ashes to ashes and dust to dust. He took dust and he scraped it together and he breathed life into this dust. Why? Because he desired image bearers, people who would live with one another in relationship, just as God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit lived together in relationship. He desired to be in relationship with us, and he desired and created us for with relationship with him and with one another. He desired to make himself known to someone. And marriage is us practicing this, living this out, that we would make ourselves who we really are in intimate closeness, make ourselves known to someone and be known in return, trusted in return, loved and cherished in return. I'd like to turn to 1 John chapter 4, verses 11 to 12, and read from the scriptures there. This says, "Dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is made complete in us." That's what we seek for marriage. That as you guys love one another, his love would be made complete. That you guys would be image bearers of the Creator God in loving one another. 1 John 3:16, this is the other John 3:16, says this. This is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for one another. Jesus Christ laid down his life for us in a self-sacrificial act. The Lord of the universe said, "I will leave my throne, and I'll come to earth to walk amongst you, to be one of you, be with you, so that you can know me, so that I can be known by you." It was God revealing himself to us, to his image bearers, in an act of love. And that act of love did not look like pomp and circumstance. It was not about fame and vanity. it was about self-sacrifice. It was about knowing those and sacrificing for those who we cared so deeply. He is our example. He is who we follow as we learn to love one another. And it says that the church, God's people, are the bride of Christ. And so as you guys walk out your marriage together, you guys are bearing God's image, Christ's image to the world by the way you love them, the way you sacrifice for them, the way you respect and cherish and treat one another as you walk through life. You get to carry this gospel message to the world. Justin asked me to challenge him with a certain scripture. It's one you may have heard before, but in Ephesians chapter 5. It's instructions for Christian households. How do we love one another? How do we serve one another in this relationship? It's a large passage, but I'm going to read it to us aloud here. It comes from Ephesians chapter 5, verses 21, starting with 21. It says, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. You guys are working to one up one another in your service and your love to one another. First come instructions for wives, the head of the church, his body, of which he is the Savior. Now, as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. This takes the form of self-sacrifice. It takes the form of respect. Alejandra, in your marriage, you are going to answer deep-seated questions for Justin that plague him. Things that he has carried around for years in his life and wondered about, things he has been nagged by, questions like, do I have what it takes as a husband, as a man? God has placed you uniquely in his life to help answer this question, to reinforce what God is already telling Justin is. As God's image bearer, you will help answer that question as you submit to him and as you respect him. Justin, here's for you. Husbands, love your wives. That's self-sacrifice. Love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. You are without stain or wrinkle here today, looking beautiful. This means, Justin, that you are to serve her and sacrifice for her to see her become all that God envisioned her to be. That you are to build her up and encourage her and spur her forward to see her reach her full potential for the kingdom. That you would answer those deep-seated questions about who she is, reinforcing what God already says about her, that you are loved. And you are cherished. And you keep repeating these questions or these answers throughout life, through our actions, through our service, through our self-sacrifice for the one we love. It's romantic. We will continue to romance one another long after the wedding day is over. Let me read on. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever hated their own body, but they feed and care for their body just as Christ does the church. For we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I'm talking about Christ and the church. Each one of you also must love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband. I'd like to pray a blessing over you guys before we share vows with one another. I want to pray a blessing over your marriage. So if you guys will join me in bowing your heads, we're going to ask the Creator God to bless this union. Father God, we love you, we submit to you, and we ask for your blessing upon this marriage. Father, we have seen your blessing poured out upon mankind in glorious, miraculous ways throughout history. And we remember those moments here today. We celebrate those moments here today, because it gives us hope for a glorious future. Jesus, we look forward to your return someday. Today we are simply acting out the greater story. We're rehearsing it for your final return, when you come back to join your bride here and we celebrate with a feast. Father God, we pray your blessing upon this marriage, Lord, that we would see children as a part of this family. Father, that they would grow in their faith and their trust in you through the trials, through the difficulties, through support of one another. Father, we pray that they would grow in their knowledge of you, in wisdom and understanding, as they understand this mystery of Christ and this church through this relationship. Father God, I pray that their love for one another would be a testament to love, that they would bear your image, that they're, because of the love for one another, that your love would be multiplied, Lord, and they would be able to turn around and be conduits of love to the world around them. That they would be able to love and serve others because they've practiced on each other, because they know they're supported, because they're filled up and ready to turn around and serve the world around them. Father, we pray all these things in your powerful, mighty name. Amen. All right. So here we get down to business. All right. At this time, we're going to share vows that Justin and Alejandra have written for one another, to one another. And they're going to declare before each of you this commitment that they have for one another. And then they will exchange some rings. So if you'd like to pull out your vows, Justin, you go first. Cash fan, yeah, have the rings.
Alejandra, you're my beloved. In your absence, I long for your presence. In your presence, I long for your touch. I'll trust your every word and have faith in all your actions. I vow to respect you, to pursue you. I vow to serve you and to love you. Where you go, I will be. When your heart aches, I'll comfort it. When your heart is joyful, I will rejoice. I'll never leave you nor forsake you, better or for worse. Am I mortally committed to you until the last moment I draw breath? May the Lord deal with me, be it ever so severe, if anything but death cuts me from you.
Right, Justin. Before the Creator God and all these witnesses, do you take Alejandra to be your wife?
Yeah.
Place this ring on your finger. Your other hand. There we go. She's just testing you. Alejandra, this ring serves as a symbol of these vows. Justin has vowed to you. All right, Alejandra, it's your turn.
Sorry, hold on. Thank you. It's not going to be as poetic as Justin, but my time with you has been filled with much joy and learning your own. We've had rough times, but despite it all, you haven't given up on me. I'm committed to do the same for you. I want to keep going by your side to support you in any way I can. And if you struggle, we're struggling together. So now I love you. I love you very much. I am very excited to come along. I just want to see what I see.
All right, great job, you two. Alejandra, for the Creator God and all these witnesses, do you take Justin to be your husband?
I do.
All right, take this ring. Place it on his finger as a sign of your vows that you carry with you this day, from this day forward. All right, you guys did a great job. We're almost there. I'm going to step out of the way so the photographers can do their thing. But before God and all of these witnesses, it is now my honor, my joy, my privilege to pronounce you husband and wife. Justin, you may kiss your bride.
everyone. Let's give these two a hand. I get to announce to you all for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Tarr.
I've heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fourth.